Hey, it's Jordan here and welcome back to the channel. Today we are checking out the Castle Mansion. Now this place is massive. It is huge. And I've already have spent a good hour and a half here just checking out the place and taking my photos. So now it's time to make my video. So the owners actually ended up owing the bank or someone like $14,000. And basically if they didn't, they were gonna be getting kicked out. So I think that's exactly what happened because everything is left behind in this house and this beautiful mansion. So enough talking from me, let's get to the video. So I wanted to give you an exterior view of this castle mansion just because it is most likely one of a kind, especially in this area. So the notice on the door is from the bailiff and explaining that they owe $14,000, which is where I got my information from. Now everyone has a lot of theories of what happened to the family. I mean, everything is left behind in this house. So, I mean, there's a lot of speculation. So this is the main entrance. They have a really nice table and toy dinosaur, T-Rex actually. There's lots of kid stuff here. I don't know how many kids this family had or whether there was multiple families here. I guess no one really knows unless you start kind of going through the information on papers that are scattered throughout the house. So we're gonna take the stairs to get up to the main level and we're gonna check out this living room, I guess. So as you can see, this place is pretty trashed. And let's go check out this real fireplace. It is really big. Yeah, this place was getting really crazy within the last couple weeks and I've already spent so much time here already, probably more than an hour and a half now. And so far I have been alone. Big, huge windows. I actually couldn't find any info about when this house was built because I did check these windows, but they were from like 2015, so not very accurate. But if I do find some information, I will put it in the description. So, oh man, this house is huge. Okay, really cool staircase. Probably one of my favorite features of this house. As I said, lots of things left behind. It's really impossible to show you everything because there's just so much. So yeah, the Chinese family lived here. There's lots of Chinese things. But first we're gonna go check out this first bathroom here on the left. Very nice. It's hard to kind of pick what rooms were used for what, but you have these really cool pocket doors. I've always liked those. A little too much noise there. Gas fireplace. A lot of expensive stuff still left inside here. Lots of mail. Like that mirror is definitely not cheap. Even this table cabinet thing. Oh, I almost forgot to show you that. That's a pretty cool light fixture, actually. So we're gonna take a left here, but first I will show you this massive chandelier. That thing is huge, but we can take a better view of it when we go upstairs. Maybe this was the dining room or one of the dining rooms. Obviously, this is a dining room as well. What do we got? Vitamins. Havana Club, some batteries, anyone need a toaster? Got clothes in here, oven, microwave. This is a really big island actually. Oh, got a wine rack, and you have pots and pans. There's probably food still around, but yeah, it's really hard to say when the last time someone was living in here. I guess I probably could check out some of these dates on the food, but I don't know if I really have time for that. I will always be your side. That's cute. All right, let's check the date on this. June 6th, 2022. That big rooster. All right, enough talking from me. Oh yeah, there's definitely some food left. What's in this fridge? Oh, ooh, that smelled. So anyways, that is the kitchen. There's lots more to see, so I don't really want to take too much time in the kitchen. That's an interesting spot for sink. All right, so now we are at the calendar and it is for March 2021. So within 2 years that this place has become this. Maybe. So, if I'm not mistaken, the master bedroom is over here. So, we will go this way. This door, I believe, just leads you to the outside. Yeah, we'll take a gander into the backyard. Basketball net. And there's a pond and gazebo. More of the castle. All right, let's head back inside. I can hear frogs in the pond, which is cool. This chair is pretty awesome, I must say. I like how it's just sitting here. Now, this room smelled really bad when I came in, and it smells right now. Got a bunch of Corona cans that aren't even open, and some Coors Light. Oh, I can't describe what it smells like, but it just smells really bad. So now we're into the first bedroom. Whether this was the master bedroom or not, there is another bedroom that's obviously not as big upstairs, but let's just say this is the master bedroom. So you have a photo album of people that lived here. Pretty crazy. It's pretty awesome furniture. I know it looks really fancy, but I can tell like it's like spray painted. It looks really fancy, but it's definitely not really expensive furniture. So you have a desk, monitor. There's actually a bunch of computers here. This family actually had a lot of money because in the closets, it's basically all like Louis Vuitton and Chanel and Prada, Holt and Renfrew. I mean, that's not like a super expensive company, but they got a Chanel box, they got a Louis Vuitton box. Closet is pretty cool. Walk-in closet hallway. Got a Prada box from Holt and Renfrew for $790. Holy. It's really expensive. I don't even know what I'm stepping on. So this house is getting some mold and some water damage. So that's it for the master bedroom. God, we haven't even gone upstairs, but we'll go into the it's basically the ensuite, but it's not connected to the bedroom. Huge glass shower. Those ones are fun to do. Big mirror. Got two sinks. And of course they have a tub, but filled with children stuff. And more children stuff, and a bidet, and a TV. Can't go wrong with that. So I think that is it for the main floor. Now let's check the upstairs. Upstairs we go, and I will have to show you the skylight up here because I really like them. You have a baby gate, and I'll show you. The baby's name was Ryan. It's a very Chinese name, I must say. There's some sort of flying insect. So upstairs had been another office. Lots of books and magazines. A printer, more computer towers, tons of stuff, tons. So here is what the view looks like. Really cool. I really love this house. I swear, like every time I go to a house, I don't think that another mansion could beat it, but I don't know. I've had a pretty good day so far. So I'll give you a view of the chandelier from up here now. So we're going to go into this room, and I have no idea what room this was. This was like a bedroom, but so you have a nice walk-in closet, not too big. Some couches. You have a Dolce & Gabbana bag. This family really knew how to spend their money. And maybe that's why they're in debt. Just saying. Okay, maybe this place is falling apart, because I just noticed that now. But anyways, I already showed you this part before, so we're going to go back inside and check out this bathroom in here. Got a tub. Again, nice vanity, nice toilet, and a decent size glass shower. So now we're heading to this other bedroom here on the left. Some clothing, boxes, there's some Lego in there. Let's check out this bathroom. It's a very long mirror. Yeah, this shower isn't really that nice. I do like how like the vents are coming from the actual like walls up there and not down. So that's bedroom number two. Now, this bedroom is pretty crazy. So we got some more Louis Vuitton boxes and a Coach one over there. Really big bedroom. I'm sure this bed was not cheap at all. Water-based lubricant. Cool. Oh, we even have a wig down there too. What? There's a sink? Whoa, that was a little bit loud. We got some more family photos. It would have been cool if those photos were taken here, but I don't recognize that room. That's cool. That's what I want in my room. So you got a fireplace. Let's check out the view from up here. So over there, right there, that's a gun safe, and someone threw it. I don't know whether there was guns in it or not, but they're not there now. It's a nice TV. So let's go check out the bathroom. Okay, that's nice. Bidet. Of course you have to have a TV. A nice jacuzzi tub. Really cool vanity, actually. Really nice shower. With a towel bar. That's ain't cheap. I can tell you that. But that's really cool. So I think that's it for upstairs. Now for the basement, actually not basement, the downstairs. The downstairs is really big as well, and there's a massive pool. The pool room is just huge, but we'll get there. So on the left, we have a wine rack room. All of these are empty, maybe besides a few, but it can definitely hold a lot of wine. And cigars. The hell is this? 53% alcohol. Damn, that's strong. So that's this room. Pretty cool. Now across from there is another bathroom, just a half bath. So I was gonna show the pool and this room at the end, but since I'm here, like, oh, this place is crazy. Actually, I just noticed this now. There is this big circle, and I'm just gonna assume that this spins. It has to. Of course it does. So you could gamble or something, or maybe eat, have some sushi, spin it to everyone around the circle. Got a big suitcase. And a big tree stump. I'm sure, like, just that alone is worth quite a bit. Holy. But anyways, that's pretty cool. Like, I can imagine this thing is very expensive. And just, like, in the chairs alone, wow. So we're gonna go check out the pool room now. And what is to the right? Oh, it's super moldy in here. So you have a stand-up shower and hooks. Probably for bathing suits, I assume. So here is the pool room. Wow. place is pretty nuts. You even have some of those chairs that still have wrappings on the legs still. Sorry, I'm just reading something. Interesting. What I think is pretty crazy about in here is that it kind of seems like all of these are like seats for people, except for the ones with the vents. But I don't know, just the way it's kind of tiled, it kind of looks like everyone would have their own seat. Got some algae growing in here. Yeah, this place, especially in the basement, it's pretty rough. Yeah, some more computer towers. Snowblower. I got the pool stuff. Interesting. So, not much in here. So obviously this pool room is super cool. A lot of people thought that having this, I can't speak English. Having this right there is weird, but I feel like it's cool because if you're swimming around and you're like drinking with your buddies and stuff, you can just put your glassware on top of that while you're swimming and then you don't have to get out of the pool. You know what I mean? I actually never went down here into like the basement, but I can imagine it's just a lot of junk. But I feel if I didn't show you what's in here, it's just storage. Like how many things do these people have? We haven't even got to the other rooms yet. Christmas, mold, more Christmas stuff. Christmas ornaments. So, continuing on. I don't know what that is. Please sign here. Ryan's first birthday. It would have been cool if it had like a date on it. Furnace room. Never interesting. So we're just gonna finish up downstairs with the Bowflex. You got a Bowflex, you got a treadmill, an elliptical. And again, just more boxes of clothing. Now, this room is pretty cool. The theater room. The ceramic plate remains hot after cooking. Whoa, it's a hot plate, but like an Asian, Chinese version. Whoa, that is cool. Okay, I definitely want to invest in one of those. Okay, so we got Chinese DVDs. Don't know any of those titles. We got a Heineken can. Don't know if it's expired. So they got all the wiring, little bar fridge, got the DVD players. Bunch of mattresses, and there's the screen. That's cool. Well, that was pretty intense. So this is actually pretty cool. I mean, watching movies like on a mattress or like, if I don't know, I feel like this room's kind of missing some couches. But yeah, really cool bar. So we're gonna hang a left. I know, I feel like this house is never ending. So in this room down here, nice little bathroom. So this was a bedroom. Obviously there is a bed and TV. I'm not sure what's over here again. Oh, just nothing. Oh, there's some crutches. So over here on the left is part of the garage. Now, I thought this was probably one of the weirdest things about this house was that, so this is a garage, but you have these glass, it's like a glass closet, like inside the garage, and then it just leads to nowhere. That's when you know you have money. So this is the outside. Well, technically a two-car garage, because you won't be parking your car inside here. I mean, you could, but so we can go into the garage and you have furniture that's still wrapped. Oh geez, wow, you even have more couches. Oh, there's a safe. Oh, pool table. I don't know. What doesn't this house have? You know what I mean? It's pretty crazy. And it's all just gonna get, like, obviously a lot of this stuff's junk, but at the same time, yeah, it's just gonna be thrown out. But I promise you, we're coming to the end of the video, because this is even really long for myself. But I have one more room to show you, and it's nothing but junk. So that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm actually gonna go, oh, you know what, I forgot, there's a room over here. The laundry room is actually a lot smaller than I thought. I was starting to think, I'm like, wait, we haven't shown the laundry room yet. But yeah, that is it. Now I'm gonna take these stairs up back to the kitchen, and we'll wrap this video up. I hope you enjoyed this video. Now, I know it was really long, but as you can see, this house was massive. So if you're not subscribed to me, please do. It would really mean a lot to me. And you can follow me on social media at Liltattyy. And yeah, this was a long one. I'm tired now. So I'll catch you guys on the next one. Stay safe.